Italy will continue to do its part to further strengthen fiscal sustainability and enhance potential growth.
That was Italian Prime Minister Mario Monti last night in New York, and no doubt he would be heartened by today's bond auction. Rome sells 6.65 billion euros of debt, that's more than planned, and yields fall. I'm Jamie McGeever, and this is today's Market Pulse. Well, John Wraith, Global Fixed Income Strategist at Bank of America Merrill Lynch, joins me now. John, a decent auction all round for Italy, I suppose. They managed to avoid major fallout from yesterday's sell-off.
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, the problem is when we have days like yesterday and a sort of headlong sell-off, nobody's quite sure where it's left the market with regard to perceived valuations. And the nerves are obviously stretched already going into auctions of peripheral debt, more so when, as I say, you know, things have lost a little bit of touch with the fundamentals. So it was a nervous run-up to the auction and a relief, as you say, that it did ultimately go very well.
That said, though, John, demand wasn't particularly great, and there was data from the ECB today that showed Italian banks and Spanish banks trimming their holdings of the respective government bonds in August.
Yeah, I mean, I think on that second point, I think it's probably more about the fact that in August there were some non-domestic buyers of Italian and Spanish debt because of their perception about what was going to be announced by the ECB at the beginning of September. And indeed, those investors then had a very good run because yields did indeed fall quite sharply. The problem is, of course, that we're here now 3 weeks after the ECB meeting and they're not actually buying anything, because nobody's asked for entry into a programme, which is the condition for the ECB to do that. So having had that good run, you may find that those non-domestic investors have exited what were probably some fairly short-term positions for them.
You talk about entering a programme, and of course the pressure and the focus is very intense, and it's on Spain in particular. Do you think Mario Monti in Italy will take a lesson from Spain and think maybe now's the time to go into a bailout programme from a position of relative strength compared to Rajoy's relative weakness?
Well, I mean, I'm sure there's always negotiations going on in the background, which include those leaders reflecting how they perceive their economic strengths and weaknesses. And there is an argument, perhaps, for Italy to do that before the spotlight turns fully on them. But, of course, these programmes involve some fairly direct and heavy monitoring by the ECB, the IMF and the EU. And that's the main reason that these countries tend to be dragged kicking and screaming into programmes rather than entering them semi-voluntarily. It's why Spain is continuing to wait despite the re-emergence of all the stresses that we've seen over recent days. And it's why we think Italy will also hold its ground until perhaps in due course it becomes more inevitable that they will have to seek help.
What are you telling your clients, John? Are you saying sell Spain and sell Italy or buy both?
Well, we're suggesting with regard to countries like that investors stay very nimble. Opportunities like that presented by the ECB a few weeks ago, you know, are definitely worth taking advantage of. This backup in yields, we think, could go further, but in the fullness of time, we think the ECB will indeed step up. So there's a sort of timing issue there, but more fundamentally, we're suggesting staying very much in core assets and safe havens because, unfortunately, we think the turmoil will get significantly worse before it gets better.
OK, John, thank you very much. Now on to our chart of the day, and it's a pretty grim chart. Shares of the world's second biggest retailer, H&M, hammered by disappointing Q3 numbers. Pre-tax earnings came in well below expectations at 4.9 billion Swedish crowns. Earnings hit by the economic slowdown and unusually hot weather in August. Margins also hit by the strong crown and expansion costs. H&M shares down almost 6% as we speak. If they stay that way, that would be the biggest one-day sell-off this year. Well, that's all for now, but do stick with Reuters. As mid-market car makers struggle to compete with low-cost competitors and prestige brands, we speak to the CEO of Renault Nissan on his strategy for survival. That's coming up on the Insider platform and Reuters.com. I'm Jamie McGeever. This is Reuters.